Hi, I'm Bob Plankers. I'm a technical marketing architect with VMware Corporation, and I'd like to introduce the vSphere Trust Authority, or VTA. VTA is a foundational piece of technology that allows us to take workloads that require a higher level of trust, ones that have encryption enabled, VM encryption, virtual TPMs and the like, and tie that to a hardware root of trust in order to be able to establish trust all the way up from the hardware to the workload itself. What is a hardware root of trust? When I say that, I mean the trusted platform module inside of a server. A TPM is just a chip inside a server that helps measure, process, and report on the boot process for an operating system like ESXi. In turn, we can use that information to do something that's called attestation. Attestation is just simply ensuring that the configuration and the boot process ran as we expected, and it booted a known good operating system in a known good configuration. Let me show you how we establish that root of trust. First, we need to create a TCB, a trusted computing base, or the VTA cluster itself. This can be your existing management cluster, if that's part of your design, and then you've got separate workload clusters. But for the most secure implementations, we recommend this be a separate cluster and implement the least privilege principle. Small group of admins, adminning just that VTA cluster. This allows us to use this cluster then to attest, to verify the workload clusters. And in turn, mark them if they pass attestation, their configurations are known good, they're running the copy of ESXi that we trust, we can mark them as trusted. This has got a few practical implications to it. Like I said, you can build a separate cluster. You don't need to use the same hardware as the workload clusters or your management cluster. You can use your management cluster. You can use smaller pieces of hardware if you'd like. You don't need separate vCenter server instances. You don't need separate VTA clusters for different vCenter server instances. You can reuse the VTA cluster for multiple vCenter instances and vSphere instances. You also need TPM 2.0 support in all of your hardware. Most servers you buy now will have that in it, or it's an installable option. Most servers that have been manufactured in the last decade can be retrofitted with it. Just check with your server manufacturer. There's some other practical implications. Traditionally, with VM encryption, things like that, the KMS systems and the vCenter server instances talk to each other, and then vCenter handles distribution of the key material to the ESXi host. In this model, vCenter doesn't talk to the KMS. The VTA cluster talks to the KMS, and then cryptographic materials flow out from there, and so on and so on. This may also have implications for KMS licensing, so you might want to check on that. Last, this also means that this cryptographic material will not be pushed to a server that isn't trusted, that doesn't pass attestation, isn't marked as good. So if we've got an untrusted server here, perhaps a configuration change happened, maybe somebody disabled secure boot. That would definitely make a server more untrustworthy, less trustworthy. This cryptographic material would not flow to that. VTA would not mark it as trusted. And then a workload that is trusted could not start or move to this host. That's exactly what we want, right? We don't want our trusted workloads on untrusted hardware. Like I said, VTA is a very foundational technology, and we're proud of it for a number of reasons. Not only does it improve security, but it does it in a way that's light on operational staff as well. Y'all have enough to do with your lives, so making it easy to be more secure is a definite goal of ours. Hopefully this answers some questions about VTA. Thank you for watching.